Hello guys, welcome to my channel Swati Pharma Gnan, sharing knowledge. Today's topic is anti-helminthics. We'll see what are helminthics, the introduction of helminthics, what is the classification of anti-helminthic drugs, definition of anti-helminthics along with the structures and its mechanism of action. Coming to introduction, helminthics are parasitic to both humans and animals. They are derived from two phyla. First phyla is Platyhelminthes, second one is Nematyhelminthes. They are also called as nematodes. Platyhelminthes are subclassified into two families. First one is cystodes and second one is trematodes. Cystodes are called as tapeworms, trematodes are called as flukeworms. Nematyhelminthes or nematodes are called as true roundworms. So by the name we can understand clearly that tapeworms means they will be like the sellotape size. Flukeworms are like pin or hook like that. True roundworms means they are in round shape. Infection of helminthes are called as infestation. So here we should not call this helminthes infection as infection. We should call it as infestation. Coming to definition of anti-helminthics, these are the drugs that have capability to get rid. To get rid means we have to expel off from the body of parasitic worms or helminthes are called as anti-helminthes. So these are the drugs which have the capability to expel or to remove or to get rid of from the body of parasitic worms or helminthes from the patient body are called as anti-helminthics. Classification of anti-helminthics is, first class is phenols and its derivatives. Examples are niclosamide and pithionol. Piperazine derivatives examples are piperazine citrate, diethyl carbamazine citrate. Anti-malarial agents can also be used in the treatment of helminthic infestations, quinacrine and chloroquine. Other heterocyclic compounds like pyrantoyl palmoate, mebendazole, thiabendazole, albendazole, natural products or ivermectin. Miscellaneous compounds are tetrachloroethylene, antimony, potassium, tartarate. Now we'll see the structures one by one. The first class of drugs are phenol and its derivatives. The first structure is bithionol and niclosamide. What is phenol? Phenyl ring with OH group is called phenol. So here two phenols are present. So that's why it is a phenol derivative. Thio indicates sulfur is sulfur. So two phenols are linked with sulfur atom, and this phenol rings contains at second position and at fourth position they contains two chloro groups. So bi indicates two phenol rings are attached with one central sulfur atom. That is structure of bithionol. Niclosamide is another phenol derivative which is used in the treatment of helminthic infestation. So here the basic nucleus is phenol, because it is also a derivative of phenol. The phenol ring contains chloro group at para position, and here one amide group is present as a bridge between parachlorophenol and metachloronitrobenzene. This is meta position. Nitro will act as a functional group. So this is nitrobenzene. To this nitrobenzene at meta position, chloro group is present. Between parachlorophenol and metachloronitrobenzene, amide group is present. That is structure of niclosamide. Both are used as a anti-helminthic drugs. Class of drugs are piperazine derivatives. The two examples under piperazine derivatives are piperazine citrate and diethyl carbamazine citrate. Piperazine citrate is the example. Piperazine, only the structure, the basic nucleus piperazine we have to write here. What is piperazine? It is a saturated pyrazine. What is pyrazine? Six membered ring containing two nitrogens at first and fourth position is called pyrazine. If it contains double bonds, then we have to call it as pyrazine. If it is completely saturated, then we have to call it as piperazine. So here citrate is attached with the piperazine, that is piperazine citrate. Uses are, it is an anti-helminthic drug used in the treatment of pinworm infestation. Pinworm, name of the helminthus is Enterobius vermicularis, and roundworm infestations, Ascaris lubricoides infestation. Mechanism of action of piperazine citrate is, it blocks the response of Ascaris muscle to acetylcholine. There is a muscle in the helminthus body of the parasite, that is Ascaris muscle, which will respond to the acetylcholine. When acetylcholine will respond, when this muscle will respond to the acetylcholine, the contraction and relaxation of the parasite takes place. But here, it when the drug is incorporated into the patient, it will cause flaccid paralysis in the parasitic worm, which is dislodged from the intestinal wall, and it will expel in the fecal matter because of the loss of contraction and loss of relaxation. It will become completely paralyzed. The next structure under piperazine derivative is diethyl carbamazine citrate. Diethyl, two ethyl groups are present to the nitrogen, and this nitrogen is attached to the carbonyl group, and this is the piperazine group, and here one methyl group is present. This diethyl carbamazine is combined with the citrate to give the complete name, that is diethyl carbamazine citrate. It is also effective against various forms of filariasis, including Bancroft's, onchocerciasis, laviasis, and ascariasis. The next category of the next class of the anti-helminthic drugs are quinacrine and chloroquine, which are anti-malarial drugs. Here, quina and quin indicates it contains quinoline ring here in chloroquine, acridine ring in case of quinacrine. So this is acridine ring. What is acridine ring? Two phenyl rings. In between, there is a pyridine ring is fused. That is structure of acridine. To this acridine, chloro group is present at this position. And here methoxy group. And here NH, CH, CH3, CH2, CH2, CH2 means isopentyl group is present. This isopentyl group is attached to one more amino group. To this amino group, two ethyl groups are present. That is complete structure of quinacrine. The same side chain is present in chloroquine also. And here in chloroquine, the acridine basic nucleus is not present. Here quinoline basic nucleus is present. What is quinoline? Quinoline is benzene fused with pyridine is called quinoline. And chloro group is present at 7th position. Uses are, it is anti-malarial drug. Even the malaria is also a protozoal disease, which is caused by Plasmodium species. That's why it can be effective in the treatment of various other helminthus infestations. It is effective against worm infestation. Next, other heterocyclic compounds are pyrantel palmoate. This is structure of pyrantel palmoate. This is palmoate structure, we have to remember. And this pyrantel structure is, it contains thiophene ring and it contains pyrimidine ring. Both are combined with CH double bond CH. So that ethene bridge is attached between thiophene and pyrimidine. And here one more methyl group is present. Uses are, it is used in the treatment of various helminthus infestations, which are caused by pinworm and roundworm. The mechanism of action is, it is depolarizing neuromuscular blocking agent. So that will cause paralysis, spastic paralysis, so that the complete contraction and relaxation of the muscles of parasitic worm will get affect in susceptible helminth. Next one is albendazole. Here azole indicates it contains imidazole. Imidazole is confused with benzene, so this is benzimidazole. All this albendazole, mebendazole and thiabendazole are the heterocyclic compounds which contain basic nucleus is benzimidazole. To this benzimidazole, yes, CH2CH2CH3 means thiopropane group is present at this position, and here NHCOOCH3 is present, that is albendazole structure. It is a anti-helminthic drug. Next structure is mebendazole. Mebendazole also contains the basic nucleus benzimidazole, and between the benzimidazole and one more phenyl ring there is a carbonyl bridge is present, and here NHCOOCH3 is common like albendazole. It is a broad spectrum antihelminthic. Always there are two types of drugs. One is narrow spectrum and another one is broad spectrum. Narrow spectrum means if any drug is acting on only single species, if it is effective on single species and not effective on other species, then we'll call it as narrow spectrum antihelminthic or narrow spectrum antibiotic or narrow spectrum drug. Broad spectrum means if it is very effective against various types of the species, various types of the microorganisms, then we'll call it as broad spectrum drug or broad spectrum antihelminthic. It is effective against a variety of nematode infestations like whipworm infestation, pinworm infestation, roundworm infestation and hookworm infestations. Mechanism of action is it is irreversibly blocks glucose uptake in susceptible helminthus. The glucose will be uptaken by the parasitic worm to produce the energy for the movement in the intestinal wall that will get blocked by using this mebendazole. Thereby it depletes glycogen storage which is present in the parasite. Once the storage of the glycogen is completely utilized by the parasite, then it will get affected. So it will also inhibit the cell division in nematodes. Next structure is thiabendazole. Thia indicates thiazole is attached to the benzimidazole. So such a simple structure is thiabendazole. Benzimidazole is attached directly with the thiazole. What is thiazole? It's 5-membered ring containing sulfur and nitrogen at first and third position with two double bonds is called thiazole. So at fourth position it is directly linked with the benzimidazole, that is structure of thiabendazole. It has a broad spectrum antihelminthic activity and used to treat enterobiasis, strongyloidiasis means threadworm infestation, ascariasis, uncinariasis means hookworm infestation. Mechanism of action is the mechanism of action of thiabendazole, albendazole and mebendazole all are different. It inhibits helminth specific enzyme, that is fumarate reductase. Fumarate reductase is the enzyme which is specific in helminthus that will get inhibited by this thiabendazole. It also arrests nematode cell division in metaphase by interfering with the microtubule assembly. When it will bind with the tubulin protein and it will affect the assembly of the microtubule, then the metaphase stage cannot complete, so that anaphase and telophase cannot complete. So cell division will completely blocked or arrested by this thiabendazole. They exhibit a high affinity for tubulin, which is a precursor protein for microtubule synthesis. So here the tubulin protein is the main protein which is required for the synthesis of microtubule during the metaphase stage of mitotic cell division. So that will get affected by this thiabendazole. The natural products which are used in the treatment of helminthus infestation is ivermectin. This is structure of ivermectin where it contains hexose sugars and it also contains benzene ring with the furan. Benzofuran is present as a basic nucleus and various other substituents are attached like methoxy groups and methyl groups and hydroxy groups, COO group like that. Ivermectin is a member of a family of structurally complex antibiotics. Actually, it is related to one family member of antibiotics, that is which is completely structurally complex antibiotics produced by fermentation with the strains of Streptomyces avermitilis. So from that species or from that strains by fermentation we can produce this ivermectin, which is a complex antibiotic. Uses are it is active against nematode infestation. All the types of nematode infestations can be treated by this ivermectin. It is effective for the treatment of onchocerciasis. What is onchocerciasis? Onchocerciasis is also called as river blindness, which is caused by roundworm Onchocera valvolus, that will cause the a disease, that is river blindness, which will affect the eye of person. Miscellaneous category of antihelminthic drugs are tetrachloroethylene. Tetra indicates 4, chloro 4 chlorine groups are attached to the ethylene. What is ethylene? It is a alkene. So C double bond C Cl 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 is the structure of tetrachloroethylene, which is active against both nematode infestation and trematode infestations. The last drug under antihelminthic drugs is potassium antimony tartrate. Potassium antimony tartrate. Potassium antimony tartrate is the structure. It is used against schistosoma, means blood fluke infestation. The disease name is schistosomiasis. So this is the blood fluke which will cause the infestation in the patient body like this. The blood red color spots can be appear on the skin because of schistosoma infestation. Thank you all.